it just really spoke to me in a way that no script really ever has. At the beginning of the film, Emily sees Luke through these rose-tinted glasses. He's very intoxicating. They live a very similar lifestyle. You know, you feel that chemistry.
Morning.
Morning.
My character believes he's up for this huge promotion, and then his girlfriend gets that promotion and he ends up working under her, and the rest of the movie explores what happens when he is unable to handle that.
So many women can relate to how she navigates and has to face the male-dominated world that she's in, and also really catering to her partner's ego.
And how do you expect people to take you seriously when you dress, you know, like a fucking cupcake?
Luke slowly picking at her, what she's wearing, and kind of getting under her skin in that way is very unsettling to her.
Luke is really aspiring to be a good person, wants to be a good person, is attracted and drawn to Emily's ambition and power, and yet there's a line that he's unable to deal with.
I told you twice I wanted you to finish the analysis before we made it.
Every firm was jumping on it.
When the walls come down, there's a lot of insecurity in Luke that you slowly see coming into play.
Can I buy another?
Now that you're making more money than me.
This film really explores how women are still so undermined in the workplace and undervalued and still have to navigate so many obstacles to get to the top, essentially, or even be successful. I drew off a lot of my own experiences and my friends and women I knew, their experiences.
I think that a lot of people will have a lot of different feelings about it, and I think that's good.
I've been waiting for a movie like this for a long time, and I really hope audiences take away a lot from it.